A PDF of additional material accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Modern Witchcraft Book of Tarot, Your Complete Guide to Understanding the Tarot, by Skye Alexander, read by Daniela Acitelli. In memory of Kathleen Valentine, fellow writer, artist, friend, and one of the most talented people I've ever known. Introduction. Recording your magical journey. You probably wouldn't be reading this book if you weren't already curious about the tarot. Many turn to this most elegant oracle because they've reached a crossroads in their lives, or they're in the midst of a crisis and need help. Others are drawn to the tarot initially because of its fascinating artwork. If you're exploring a magical path as a witch, you've probably stumbled upon the tarot already and want to learn more. The tarot shows you what lies beneath the surface of situations and what's really going on in those shadowy realms beyond your ordinary range of vision. It lets you gaze into the future and see what's likely to happen. It shines light on murky matters, including your own subconscious motivations. It gives you a broader perspective so you can make better decisions. In short, it's your magic mirror, your wise counselor, a scout who goes ahead to check out the lay of the land, and your brutally honest best friend. Magic and the Tarot. You can't separate the tarot from the practice of magic and witchcraft. They're entwined. Look at the card called the Magician. He's card number one in what's known as the Major Arcana. Right there on the table before him lie the four main tools in a witch's toolbox: the wand, chalice, pentagram, and sword, or athame. Look a little further and you'll realize the four suits of the tarot's minor arcana symbolize the four elements, earth, air, fire, and water, that witches and other magicians work with in rituals and spellcraft. For more on all this, consult my books, The Modern Guide to Witchcraft, The Modern Witchcraft Spellbook, and The Modern Witchcraft Grimoire. The images that illustrate this book were created by two noted magic workers, Arthur Edward Waite and Pamela Coleman Smith, both members of an influential mystical order known as the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. Consequently, the symbols, colors, numbers, and other features on the card convey magical information. Although many people start their exploration into the tarot with this popular pack of cards, you can use any deck that appeals to you, and there are thousands from which to choose. Many decks also incorporate astrology, the Kabbalah, shamanism, and other magical systems familiar to witches. Choose the right deck. Choosing a tarot deck is a highly personal matter. You'll find a number of decks designed with witches in mind, including the Witch's Tarot, Tarot of the Witches, Everyday Witch Tarot, and Green Witch Tarot. You might also like the Sacred Circle Tarot and the Fairy Wicca Tarot. The Tarot's History and Mystery. The tarot's roots go back at least to the 15th century, and perhaps a lot farther. Many researchers believe it started out as a card game in Renaissance Europe, although other theories abound. In Chapter 2, you can read about some of the ways people in those days used cards, both for entertainment and for telling fortunes. The tarot's history is rich, complex, and a bit murky. It will probably always remain a mystery, and that's part of its appeal. If you want to learn more about the tarot's origins and evolution, You'll find lots of interesting material online and in the many books that have been written about this enigmatic oracle, in addition to what I touch on here. If you don't care, you can skip right over that chapter. You don't need to know anything about where the tarot came from or how it evolved in order to use it. The whole point of this book is to jump right in. Still, you might enjoy discovering the who, what, when, where, and why behind this amazing oracle that's held us in its thrall all these centuries. How to use this book. Getting a tarot reading from a professional cartomancer can be a most educational and enlightening experience. However, you can do readings for yourself. In fact, many people learn the meanings of the cards by experimenting on themselves. It isn't necessary for every practicing witch to be able to do tarot readings, but it's a very useful skill that will help you in other aspects of your craft. In writing this book, I've tried to make an esoteric and intricate mystical system accessible to those of you who are just starting out on this journey. To that end, I've explained in Part 2 each of the 78 cards of a typical tarot deck in what I hope is a user-friendly way, combining commonly accepted interpretations with what I've gleaned from my many years of experience. Until you become proficient at doing readings, you can look up these general meanings. With practice, you'll become adept at interpretation and come to your own, unique understanding of the tarot. In Part 3, I've included some of my favorite tarot spreads, patterns that put the individual cards into a context during a reading. In Part 4, I share lots of spells from my personal grimoire that use tarot cards in magical ways. In time, you may decide to purchase more than one tarot pack. I recommend using one for readings and another for magic work. If you decide to do readings for other people, I suggest using one deck for yourself and another when you read for other people. That means you may eventually become the proud owner of at least 3 tarot packs. Over the years, I've owned about 200 different decks. Yes, they can get addicting. Many people collect tarot packs for the artwork alone, and some rare, famous decks now reside in museums or the private collections of wealthy individuals. Does the tarot work? Regardless of the beauty, wonder, and mystery of the tarot, it probably wouldn't have stood the test of time if it didn't work. As an oracle, a tool for self-discovery, a meditation aid, a guide for personal growth, and an adjunct to magical practice. Although our ancestors may have dabbled in it as a mere amusement, that's not why most of us turn to the tarot today. Perhaps you're still asking, can the tarot really predict the future and reveal hidden information? Can it give me insight into the past and how I might handle the present? Can it help me solve problems in my life, improve my relationships with others, and fulfill my potential? The best way to find out is to try it yourself. Part 1. Getting to Know the Tarot. Chapter 1. A Little Bit About Oracles. What will tomorrow bring? Since ancient times, people throughout the world have sought answers to this question by consulting oracles. As a witch, you may already be familiar with oracles and even use them yourself. Do you gaze into a treasured crystal ball or a magic mirror to see beyond your ordinary realm of vision? Watch smoke waft away from a ritual fire, or stare into the flickering flame of a candle to gain insight? Have you cast runes, consulted the I Ching, or doused with a pendulum in search of answers? or perhaps asked a psychic or shaman for advice? The most famous oracle of all in the ancient world was the oracle at Delphi. Thousands of years ago, the Greeks trekked to Mount Parnassus, about 75 miles from Athens, to petition this famous priestess for advice. While in a trance, she tuned into the divine realm and allowed a deity to speak through her. Meanwhile, in China, court astrologers of the Zhou dynasty interpreted upcoming events in the stars, clouds, rain, and wind. The rulers of ancient Sumeria and Babylonia looked to diviner priests to reveal the future.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.